today the case of Tex MacGyver. Fulton County prosecutors believe he intentionally killed his wife, and they suggest the motive may have been money. Fox 5's Morris Diggs is live at Fulton County Courthouse, where a motions hearing started about an hour ago. Morris.
Well, they are continuing to challenge the conduct of the prosecution in this case, the senior prosecutor, Clint Rucker, for Paul Howard. Now, what they are telling the judge this morning is that time after time, they have either gathered evidence illegally or they have thrown impediments up in front of the legal team. Now, Tex MacGyver showed here in court. He has his own version of what you might call a legal dream team. His resources afford him that. But the team of lawyers, which is trying to defend him against the charge that he intentionally murdered his wife, Diane, contend the prosecution has tried to hinder their efforts at every turn. The closely watched case began with an interpretation of what happened in the family SUV as the MacGyvers and a friend were headed back from a weekend retreat. Going through a rough part of town, MacGyver had a weapon in his lap. While he dozed off asleep, he says the gun discharged, striking Diane, who was seated up front. In court, the lawyers for MacGyver complained the prosecution has repeatedly delayed handing over information to them. It's what's called discovery. One example, they say they just got a dump of 90,000 emails of Diane MacGyver. Recall, Diane was a corporate executive for a advertising company in downtown Atlanta, and they had 90,000 of them. Now, we're in the heat of the moment as they get ready for trial, and they're saying the fact that they made this dump of so many emails that they had earlier shows that they're trying to hinder them from being able to represent Mr. MacGyver in the best manner. That's one of the things the judge has to consider right now, the conduct of the prosecution. The prosecution, of course, will have a chance to defend the way it's been handling the case, and we'll have that on our news later this evening at 5 and 6. Reporting live from downtown Atlanta, I'm Morris Diggs, Fox 5 News.
Thanks, Morris, for keeping us posted on that. This